Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The month of Ramadan, the month of mercy, the month of worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the month that we will draw nearness of Allah azza wa jal. In this month, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in regards to this month, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned many virtues. One of the most beautiful virtues that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned is about prayers in the month of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man qama Ramadan," the one who stands in the month of Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaba, with faith and with the intention that he will be rewarded from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ, all his past sins will be forgiven. So in this month of Ramadan, we should all try our very best that inshaAllah ta'ala, we will offer all our prayers in congregation in the masjid inshaAllah. That should be our most important intention, that we will try our very best to attend all prayers in the masjid so that we could pray in this congregation, benefit from the environment of the masjid. If one can't pray in congregation because of other commitments and they can't attend the masjid, then try to create a congregation wherever you are, inshaAllah ta'ala, at your workplace, whatever. Try to get your friends and colleagues and try to make a small little jama'ah and offer the prayers if it's possible, inshaAllah ta'ala, so that we could get the reward of congregation. You know why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, Salatul jama'ah afdalu min salatil fadhi bi 27 daraja. A prayer that is performed in congregation, it is 27 times more superior in rewards than the prayer is offered individually. So our, inshaAllah ta'ala, will try our very best to pray our salah in congregation. Now, what happens if you can't even do that because of other commitments and because you work in an environment where you cannot find any other colleagues? Okay, then wherever you are, when the time for salah comes, try your very best to offer that prayer, inshaAllah ta'ala. Don't let the time pass and the salah becomes qada and you delay it, that the time goes, okay, and then the next prayer enters, because we don't want to be deprived from the blessings and rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why in the month of Ramadan, it should be our firm intention either to, inshallah ta'ala, to attend for all, the masjid for all prayers. If not, we're going to make our own congregation. If not, we're going to pray all the prayers, inshallah ta'ala, wherever we are, and we're not going to delay those prayers. That should be our intention, inshallah ta'ala, in the month of Ramadan. Now, there is another important prayer, as we mentioned earlier, man qama Ramadan, the one who stands in the month of Ramadan. It's called Qiyamul Layl. Okay? In addition to the obligatory prayers, the five prayers, there is another prayer called Salatul Tarawih, or sometimes Qiyamul Layl. Okay? MashaAllah, nowadays the masajid, after Salatul Isha in the masajid, they call a hafiz and is reciting the whole Quran. We will get a chance, inshaAllah ta'ala, to listen to the whole Quran if you attend, inshaAllah ta'ala, the Taraweeh prayers as well. They recite beautifully, they recite slowly, inshaAllah. It gives us the chance to now listen to the whole Quran recited. This is a prayer we should try our very best to attend as well. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, by standing in the month of Ramadan, which is Taraweeh or Qiyamul Layl, our past sins will be forgiven as well. Inshallah ta'ala, people complain sometimes, you know, it's not easy to stand for long, long hours. Let us start from now. We could make the preparation from now. How are we going to prepare now? Let us pray some long nawafil salah, inshallah. When you pray your fard prayers, after the fard prayers, pray 2 rakat nafal. Okay? Wake up in the night from now, inshallah. Take some time out and try to pray 2 rakat and recite many verses as possible. This is called getting ready for the month of Ramadan. So, Tahajjud Salah. Okay? What is Tahajjud Salah and what is Qiyamul Layl? Both of the words are used in our Sharia. It is the voluntary prayer. For us, it's a voluntary prayer. But you know, for the prophets and the special bondsmen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pious people, you know, they is to always offer the prayer in the night. Okay? In the night, they is to wake up, they is to pray. So many of the pious people that when we read their biography, we find that in the early portion of the night, they would get up and they would recite the Holy Quran. All the pious people and the biography that you have written, they used to offer the Qiyamul Layl. You know what? All the Anbiya alayhim salatu wasalam, okay, especially our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam used to stand for Qiyamul Layl so much so that, you know what? Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she used to say to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, O Prophet of Allah, can you please take some rest? Okay, why do you work so hard? Why do you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so excessively? Allah has forgiven all your past sins. Okay, and the prophets is free from sin, they are infallible. But this is what Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, that if even if you were to commit any sins, all the sins are forgiven. You know what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied? He said, أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Should I not become a grateful servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us with so many blessings. We need to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us stand in the month of Ramadan and offer Qiyamul Layl inshaAllah and Salatul Tahajjud and revive the sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazakumullahu khairan.